Let us worship God. I invite you to stand and sing the Old Hundredth while we continue to wear face masks.
In God's name we pray. I will offer to thee the sacrifice of thanksgiving. gave such a brilliant good, marking well, that in her minstrel rapture swell. And when the time was proudly made, by a minister's wealth as wish to obtain. Despite these times, power of the wretch consenting all himself, live shall forfeit.
This is a reading from Walter Scott's journal, which reflects the nadir of his life and his resilience. And he wrote, "I feel neither dishonored nor broken down by the bad, now really bad news I have received, but I find my eyes moistening, and that will not do. I will not yield without a fight for it. It is odd when I set myself to work doggedly, as Dr. Johnston would say, I am exactly the same man that I ever was. Neither will spirit it not astray. In prosperous times, I have sometimes fought my fancy and powers of language kind. But adversity is to me a beast of tonic and bracer. The phantom is awakened from its inmost recesses, as if the spirit of affliction had troubled it in his passage."
Thank you. James Graham of Clare House, Lord First Viscount of Dee, was known as, quote, bloody Claret to his enemies, but Bonnie Dundee to his royalist friends. Scots thought him a gallant, romantic soldier, and owned a miniature of him and one of his pistols. The Covenanters hated Dundee, and with good cause. When King Charles II sought to impose episcopacy and the hated Anglican prayer book on Presbyterian Scotland, he it was who commanded the cavalry at the Battle of Bothwell Brig, and later, during what was known as the Killing Time, he it was who hunted down and slew Covenanters across western Scotland. He was thought to be in league with the deal, and to be invulnerable, save only to a silver hood. The song Bonnie Dundee records an incident in the year 1689, when the Convention of Estates of Scotland met here in Edinburgh to discuss the terms under which we would accept William of Orange as our future King William III. The vote going against him, Dundee stormed out and rode across Edinburgh on his way to raise an army to fight for the exiled and deposed King James II. In his journal, superbly edited by the late Sir Eric Anderson, KT, Scott writes on the 22nd of December, 1825, "The air, Bonnie Dundee, running in my head today, I composed some verses to it before dinner. I believe they have met. The keynote was the incident of Dundee leaving the Convention of Scottish Estates in 1689. I hope they have met." Later.
Thank you.
render Roman evil for evil, but hold fast to the good, honour all of God's children, and the grace and peace of God be with you now and forevermore.